W, the voiced bilabial approximant. The most frontal of all the speech organs and the easiest to see are the two lips. And the sound W is made with the two lips very rounded, pouted right out, like this. W. Because both the lips are used to make it, the W sound is a bilabial consonant, bi meaning two and labial meaning to do with the lips. That's its place of articulation, bilabial. For W, the lips don't close the air passage completely. The air passage is somewhat restricted, but still open. See the little rounded gap between my lips. W. Sounds like this are called approximants. As the speech organs come close, they approximate to each other, but they do not make closure. That's its manner of articulation, approximant. While we're saying W, our vocal folds are vibrating. W, W, W. So it's voiced. So W is a voiced bilabial approximant. This is a typical three-part phonetic classification of a consonant sound, describing its voicing, place of articulation, and manner of articulation. Do pay close attention both to what you see in the video and to my description. When I say the sound is bilabial, I do mean it is bilabial. It is made with the two lips and does not involve the upper teeth at all. It's an approximant, which means there is no contact between the lips. They're very close to each other, but not touching. The archetypal spellings of the W sound are the letter W on its own, as in wild, and the letters WH together, as in what, where, when, why, and most of the other question words. There is no difference in the pronunciation between W on its own and WH. The letter H does not alter the sound at all. In the word who, the sound is, of course, not W at all, it's H. At the beginning of words, QU is typically pronounced qu, as in quick, quiet, and quit. An exception is key, Q-U-A-Y, which is pronounced exactly the same as key, K-E-Y. In the middle of words, Q-U may be qu, as in banquet, but often it's not. It's often k, as in racket and Jacqueline. At the end of words, it's always k, as in technique. Very occasionally, in words of foreign origin, the W sound may be spelt O-U, as in Ouija board. The spelling UI occurs once only, as far as I'm aware, in Uyghur. Let's do some examples. Where there's more than one word in a list, it means that those words are homophones, words which are pronounced exactly alike. Here are examples of words with W in initial position. I'm going to go slowly, and the idea is that I give you time to repeat, and you listen and repeat. Waste. Waste. White. White. Where. Where. Wine. Wine. Will. Will. Wheel. Wheel. Want. Want. Woman. Woman. The W combination in a woman is a difficult one for certain learners, especially Japanese speakers, because the W sound and the following vowel sound, U, are phonetically and physically very similar. The W consonant needs the lips to be tighter than for the U vowel. And then they relax into the vowel. I'll exaggerate the movement from w to the following vowel. Woman. Woman. Would. Would. Wool. Wool. Woof. Woof. Even harder to distinguish and pronounce if you don't have the combination of sounds in your language is the glide from w to oo, as in woo, w-o-o, woo. For this, the lips are still tighter for the w consonant than for the oo vowel which follows, but the opening out into the vowel is much less noticeable. Woo, woo, woo. Woo is quite a rare combination. There's the word woo itself and womb and to wit to woo. That's only common if you're an owl. There's also woozy and whoosh and wooky hole, but the combination is uncommon and most of the words spelt W-O-O are w with a short o, like wood. Now we do examples of w in medial position, in the middle of a word. Awake. Awake. Aware. Aware. Beware. Beware. Lower. Lower. Shower. Shower. Reward. Reward. The w sound cannot occur in final position. The letter w can, but not the sound. Now let me emphasize, w must not involve the upper teeth at all, like this. That's the v sound. And this is very important. It's a very important distinction for clear pronunciation. W must be bilabial. It must have no contact with the teeth and should have no fricative noise. When we come to v, I'll contrast it with w. This is a problem if your language does not have both w and v in contrast. German comes immediately to mind as it has no w sound. Remember, every time it's spelt with a w, it must be a w. If it's spelt with a v, it must be v. Hindi, Urdu has both sounds, but they don't contrast with each other. So Hindi and Urdu speakers are often heard saying v for w in English, which can be very unclear. Now, at the end of each lesson, I'll do some sentences I've made up with as many examples of the target sound in them as I can think of. Use these for practice, but don't take them too seriously, because we would never really have that many of the same sound all in one sentence. The weary whale wished for warmer waters. The weary whale wished for warmer waters. Now you repeat. The weary whale wished for warmer waters. Why won't William just work the way we want? Why won't William just work the way we want? And now you repeat. Why won't William just work the way we want? The whereabouts of the wandering wallabies was a constant source of worry for the warden. The whereabouts of the wandering wallabies was a constant source of worry for the warden. And now you repeat. The whereabouts of the wandering wallabies was a constant source of worry for the warden. Whenever we were away from Wales, the weeds in the woods grew wild. Whenever we were away from Wales, the weeds in the woods grew wild. And now you repeat. Whenever we were away from Wales, the weeds in the woods grew wild. wuh.